I'm DEA agent Jose Varela, and I will be explaining how the Mexican cartels affect and control the Mexican government. In 2006, the war on drugs was declared by Mexican President Felipe Calderón in an attempt to stop the drug cartels that created an environment of extreme violence in Mexico. This had been caused by territory conflict among rival cartels near the US-Mexico border for better shipment routes into the United States. Eventually, the war on drugs' biggest victory would be when Joaquín El Chapo Guzmán was captured and extradited to the United States in 2017. El Chapo was, at the time of his capture, the leader and founder of the Sinaloa cartel, once believed to be the most powerful and influential cartel in Mexico. During El Chapo's trial, it was revealed how truly involved the Mexican government is with the Mexican cartels. It was discovered that politicians, prison guards, and even tax assessors had taken money from El Chapo's Sinaloa cartel in the past. During the trial, it was also stated that two previous Mexican presidents had taken bribes from El Chapo's Sinaloa cartel, but it was not officially stated who these were. However, considering that there have only been three Mexican presidents since the start of the war on drugs, odds are that you can easily find out who these are. Moreover, El Chapo's Sinaloa cartel's range and influence doesn't stop with civilians, cops, and politicians. El Chapo's trial showed that Marines and Army generals have in the past taken bribes from different cartel organizations. Even the former Public Security Director of Mexico, Genaro García Luna, the man who was supposed to direct the war against El Chapo, was accused of taking cash from the Sinaloa cartel. One can see why El Chapo managed to escape two Mexican prisons and evade justice for over 20 years. Finally, the influence of cartels over the military is seen especially in the cartel known as Los Zetas, whose founders were once part of the Mexican Army's elite airborne special forces group trained by US, Israeli, and French military in counterterrorism, counterintelligence, interrogation, and strategy tactics. They eventually left the military and were recruited by the Gulf cartel to be their enforcers. Los Zetas eventually used their military knowledge and tactics to create their own cartel, as well as to intimidate the rivals and victims. They eventually established their own territory, as seen in this diagram. In addition to the military's involvement with cartels, about 1,383 Mexican soldiers deserted the Mexican military between 1994 and 2015, many of whom landed in the hands of the cartel. In conclusion, Mexico's cartels have serious control and influence over the corrupt Mexican government, from tax assessors and cops, all the way to military generals, and even the president.